9 months later.
Dear Tim, I have to move away for a while. This is our micro steam turbine, Timmy. I named him after you. I cannot bring him with me, so you must look after him. But here's a list of his needs. 4.3 grams per second of high quality steam, a 4 bar and 150 degrees Celsius, and a 0.1 bar outlet. All my love, Tiffany.
Pressurized steam, heated by recovered thermal energy from an internal combustion engine, enters through the inlet of the turbine at 4 bar and 150 degrees Celsius. It is directed into the flow separation chamber where it is split axially into 5 nozzles on each side. The pressure drop from 4 bar to 0.1 bar across the Delaval nozzle accelerates the flow to 1000 meters per second. The reaction force of the flow passing over the blades spins the rotor and drives the shaft. A generator is then used to convert the mechanical energy of the rotating shaft into useful electrical energy.
All my friends know the low rider. The low rider is a little higher.
We did a thermal expansion analysis on the housing and stator end caps together to calculate what our tip clearance would be under operating conditions. As shown here is an exaggerated animation of them expanding together. We also did a heat transfer analysis through the turbine when in operation with both air and steam. When the turbine is in operation with air, there is a lot of localized cooling around the nozzles as shown here. This is caused by the low temperature due to the pressure drop over the nozzles. We used the heat transfer analysis of steam through the turbine as shown here to ensure that our bearings were within their operating parameters. We also did a thermal expansion analysis on the shaft and rotors together when calculating our tip clearance.
We modelled the final design of our rotor and abacus and conducted a finite element analysis. The geometry used was simplified to only one quarter of the rotor, and then a symmetrical condition was applied about the y-axis to reduce running time. We exerted a centrifugal force on the rotor as displayed. After simulation, the stresses were concentrated on the bolt hole and also the base of the blade, but still within a factor of safety of 2.56.
CFD analysis was carried out to optimize both the nozzle and blade geometries. Various nozzle geometries are modeled, and the final nozzle, illustrated here, has an elliptical profile and a converter's angle of 30 degrees and a divergence angle of 13 degrees, and was selected based on an even velocity distribution radially at the outlet of the nozzle and a smooth velocity gain axially along the nozzle as to avoid shockwaves. Here you can see an unsteady simulation of the nozzles, simulating the startup of the turbine. The flow over the blades was analyzed to determine the optimum profile and spacing of the blades and the effect that the tip clearance has on the turbine. This analysis was also necessary to ensure that all the pressure drop occurs inside the nozzle.
turbine components were manufactured from stainless steel, except for the nozzle rings, which were 3D printed using a high temperature resin. Parts were machined using a combination of lathes, milling machines, and a variety of other precision tooling. The rotors were machined using a 3-axis CNC milling machine used here to machine the end cap.
A test shaft was submersed in liquid nitrogen to cool the shaft to approximately minus 180 degrees Celsius. This would enable sufficient thermal contraction in order to assemble the collar and shaft and create a shrink interference fit. Several tests were carried out to simulate the environmental conditions the assembly would experience during steam and air testing. The test shaft was manufactured to 12 mil and the shaft collar was bored to 11.95 mil as per calculations. Once the shrink fit was formed, the assembly was allowed to return to room temperature where the shaft expanded and created the interference fit. During operation, the shaft collar transmits torque from the rotors to the shaft, therefore a torque test was performed to ensure the interference fit was suitable. The shaft was secured in a bench vise and the lever was bolted to the shaft collar. Weights were then incrementally added and suspended from the opposite end of the lever to exert the torque on the assembly.
We start the assembly with the nozzle sub-assembly. The 3D printed nozzles are bolted to the flow separation collar with 10 M3 bolts on either side. O-rings are placed in grooves in the flow separation collar to provide sealing. The bolts should be torqued in an alternating sequence to ensure the O-rings are compressed evenly. Once this sub-assembly is finished, we can put it aside for later. The next step is to assemble the housing and stator end caps. Place the O-ring around the stator end cap. Line the inside of the housing with some silicone spray for ease of assembly. Place the stator end cap into the housing with a constant and even pressure to compress the O-ring. Place the nozzle subassembly into the housing and repeat with the second stator end cap. Next, we assemble the shaft. The shaft collar was fixed to the shaft earlier using an interference fit. Place a graphite bushing and a rotor blade on one side of the shaft. Bolt the blades to the shaft collar using 4 M3 bolts. Carefully place the shaft into the housing, ensuring not to damage the blade tips. Slide the remaining bushing and rotor blade onto the shaft and bolt the blades in place. Gently press the rotary shaft seals into the end caps. Place an O-ring into the groove in the stator end cap and bolt the end cap to the housing. Repeat steps with the second end cap. Next, press the bearings into the bearing housings. Slide the bearings over the shaft and thread the bearing housings onto the end caps. Once the turbine is fully assembled, ensure that the shaft is rotating freely. The turbine is now ready for testing.
A global and national emergency. A pandemic. No parties. Colleges will close. Focus on testing.
As the COVID-19 pandemic forced the closure of University of Limerick campus, testing could not be carried out in college grounds. Luckily, one of the group members had enough safety gear to carry out testing in an environment free from COVID-19 risks and other possible dangers. Using a compressor, air was fed to the turbine inlet at 4 bar pressure and a maximum RPM of 14,000 was achieved.